What is mean by a phase sequence, balance supply and balance load? What is mean by balance system? And then we will going to derive the phase voltages and phase current and line current and line voltage, means phase and line quantities with respect to the balance system with the help of and star and delta connection. And move on to the next topic, we will going to derive the power consumed by the three phase balance load, and we will see the power in three phase Y system can be measured using 2 wattmeter method as well as 3 wattmeter method, and we will find the equation for the power factor and balanced three phase system using 2 wattmeter method. See, we are having a single phase and three phase. Specifically, why we consider three phase supply? Is there any advantage? Yes, we are having lots of advantages because of the three phase supply. First one is, in three phase machines, always at any condition, the output is greater than a single phase machine with the same size. The first advantage. The second advantage is the transmission of the power from one place to another place is very easier and economical compared to the single phase system. One more advantage is the instantaneous power in the three phase system never fall to zero, resulting in smooth and better operating characteristics of the load. What is means of instantaneous power? Okay, if I consider a three phase R, which is R, Y and B. R, Y, B. If at any condition, at any instant, the instantaneous power never zero. Okay. If I consider a single phase system, the instantaneous power is zero at a different instance. At pi and 2 pi, the power, instantaneous power is zero. Okay, and because of the nature of the three phase system, which operate in smoother way and better operating characteristic of the load. Why? Because of this nature, the rotating magnetic field, the RMF produced in the induction machine. The induction machine is very ruggedness, which operate in longer life, which drive high loads because of high torque, low initial and maintenance cost. Maintenance cost is very low. And initial cost also is low compared to the other machines. This is also one more advantage. In domestic as well as industrial commercial power application can be supplied from the three phase distribution system. Okay, why required a three phase system in three phase supply means in industrial applications we are using large machines in order to drive the heavy loads. To drive heavy loads, we require large amount of power. For that case, we need to produce large amount of power. So this is possible only because of the three phase or either polyphase system. Okay, three phase system has a better voltage regulation. We will discuss the what is voltage regulation in further classes. For time being, please make a note on this point. three phase system has a better voltage regulation. And for a given size, a particular given size machine, the power generated by the three phase alternator is very high. What is meant by alternator? Means alternator is a generator. Alternator nothing but a generator. A generator means which generates the electrical energy. Which generates the electrical energy from mechanical energy. For the same amount of size, if you consider a single phase generator, will generate a very low power, whereas a three phase alternator will generate high amount of power. This is a one more advantage. So the now we are seeing the generation of three phase supply, how it is generated. Now I am considering it is a starter. For a second, hold it. It is a starter. Starter having a statical pot. It is a rotor having the field coils. So I am considering a three phase system. For time being, let us assume A and A dash, and B and B dash, and C and C dash are the three phases. Instead of R, Y, B. This is the rotor having the two poles and south and north pole. According to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, the EMF is generated in these coils. Okay, the rotor is rotating, the flux is linking with these coils, the generated EMF will taken out from this outward terminals. See, if the rotor is linking with the red coil, means B and B dash, the sequence is generated like this. The rotor coil is linking with the blue coil, the generated EMF phase sequence is as like this. And green one, we will seeing the phase sequence of the generated EMF. See the animation video. Now we are observing the coil is linking with A and A dash, B and B dash, and C and D dash. The phase sequence corresponding shown as like diagram. Okay, so in which we are having a phases and neutrals available. Okay, basically the generation of a three phase supply having three phases R, Y, B or A, B, C. Okay, the corresponding EMF generated waves as shown in the circuit diagram. Okay, so for time being, let us consider three equations. The phase voltages corresponding to the VA or VY R, which is corresponding to VY, which is corresponding to V. So first phase is starting from the zero, means we are having the magnitude and zero phase angle. Okay, the second phase is delayed with 120 degrees, so Vm into sine omega t minus 120. I'm writing as like this. We are writing also Vb is writing as V phase an angle of minus 120 degrees, whereas the B phase voltage, which is Vc, Vm into sine omega t minus 240, so which is delayed 240 degrees from the reference. See, observe, this is starting from zero. I am considering if it is reference, it is starting from the zero, whereas B phase is starting from 120 degrees. See, in order to avoid the confusion, I am drawing which is 90 degrees, it is 180, it is 360. So 120 by 4 parts, we will 30, 60, 90, 120, 150 and 180. Similar as like that, isn't it? So it is starting from 120. So that the reference, from the reference value, it is starting delayed with 120 degree. That's why is the second equation is right like is a minus 120 degrees. Whereas the B phase voltage in figure VC, VC is related to the B. So it is starting after 240 degrees. So means this delayed from the reference is 240. Please remember, either instead of VA, VB, VC or VR, VY and VB, R, Y, B phases, R, VA, VB, VC. What is the mean of phase sequence? Phase sequence can be changed by reversing the direction of the rotor of the alternator. So phase representation and three phase EMF. So meaning of the three phase sequence we are going to learn in this slide. Three voltage of three phase system are represented by three rotating phasors. These are the rotating phasors. Okay, they have equal magnitude and maintaining phase difference of 120 degrees with respect to each other. The phasor rotation RYB sequence or RBY phase sequence in the sequence manner. In this slide, if you consider RYB, it is VR, VY, VB. The rotation is like that in clockwise direction. RYB. AR, the other phase sequence, this is RYB sequence. In the reverse direction, R B Y. If I starting from sequence is V R V B, this is V Y. See R B Y R R Y B, the reversing direction of the rotating alternator. Either if you consider A, B, C, R, R, Y, B phase sequences, these are the phase rotating sequences. For clear understanding, I'm giving you the idea about a phase sequence. Please focus on this slide. So this is the R phase, means a red phase. I'm taking as a reference phase in order to avoid the confusion. So the phase angle from red to Y phase is 120 degrees apart. See, if you consider a circle by 3, what is the angle of circle, entire circle? We're having a 360 degree upon 3, we will get 120 degrees. So means each phasor will having a distance or phase difference is 120 degrees apart each other. Okay, so this is the 120 degrees, minus 120 degrees. Why I am considering 120? I am considering clockwise rotation. So from reference to B face, it is minus 240 degrees. Similar manner, if I consider a red face as a reference, B face is 120 degrees and Y face is minus 240 degrees from the reference. So in R Y B faces, it is R Y B phase sequence. It is R B Y. R B Y phase. So now let us write the phasor voltages in each cases. If I consider first phasor is reference, VR is equal to, it is having the magnitude as VR. So zero angle means it has a zero reference. Whereas VY, VY phase or voltage is represented as the magnitude in the direction VY, an angle from reference to VY is minus 120 degrees. Whereas VB is equal to VB, the phasor volt magnitude voltage VB, and it is rotated from reference to VB is 240 degrees. So that we will write as minus 240 degrees. Okay. In RBY phases, RBY phase sequences, so reference is considered as VR. So it is phasor means having the phase and magnitude VR, an angle of 0 degrees. Whereas VB is having the magnitude as VB, an angle as minus 120. Why 120? It is rotated from the reference phase is 120. Okay. Whereas VY is having the magnitude as VY, an angle of minus 240. Why? Because the Y phasor is rotated from the reference phasor, name as VR, is minus 240 degrees. Why consider negative angle means these phasors rotated in clockwise direction. Please remember, the phasor rotation consider in the clockwise direction. These are the giving the expression of the phasor voltages in corresponding RYB and RPY phase sequences. Similar manner, the phase currents also we can write as like same. Instead of voltage, we will write currents. If I consider the phasor current R is equal to IR, an angle of 0. This is the phasor voltage in the R phases. So now we will discuss about meaning the balanced and unbalanced supply. Okay. So what is mean by balanced supply? If I consider three phasors, Y, A, B and C, three phasors having the magnitude is the same, and VA, VB, VC are magnitude same, and they are phase displaced with 120 degrees apart each other. Means VA and VB are separated with 120 degrees, and VB and VC angle is 120, and VC to VA is also 120 degrees. The system is called balanced and symmetrical. Please remember the magnitude of the phasor. Each phasor voltage are equal, as like VA, VB and VC are equal to phasor voltage, and as well as phase difference means the angle between the each phase to other phase is 120 degrees are same. So that system is called balanced system or symmetrical system. Whereas consider the second picture, the phase are equal but the phase difference is unequal. The A to B is almost 180, B to C is either greater than the 90, and A to C may or may not it is 90. Okay, so the phasor difference between the three phasor is different, not equal, means phase angles are not equal, phase angles not equal. Okay, but the phase magnitudes VA, VB, VC magnitudes are equal, but phasor or phase angle are not equal. So and third system is the phasor angles are phasors are same, they are separated with the 120 degrees each other or 120 degrees apart each other, but the phase magnitude VA, VB, VC are not equal. And third diagram, the D diagram, VA, VB, VC are not equal, and they angle are not equal. These three consider as unbalanced system or unsymmetrical system. Can you explain why? Because the either phase difference is not equal or the magnitude of phasors are not equal. That's why these system is called unbalanced system or unsymmetrical systems. In this slide, what is the meaning of balanced or unbalanced load and a system? Now consider ZA, ZB, ZC in star connected impedances, ZCA and ZBC and ZAB delta connected impedances. Please do not confuse with the nomenclature. If I consider RYB, either ABC or RYB. If the three impedances which may be our star connection or delta connection, the three phase load to be said is balanced. The load and supply both are balanced, then the entire system said to be balanced. Either load is unbalanced or supply is unbalanced, the system is unbalanced system. Both the sides, either from the supply side and load side, are balanced, then only we can say that the system is balanced system. Under normal working condition, the three phase system can be taken as balanced. Okay, under running condition, because of abnormalities, either environmental or in the supply, that leads to unbalance. But whereas under normal working condition, under normal condition, we will treat as a balanced system.